Russians made was in the assessment of where the main German attack would fall. They believed that it would come from the north, and they arranged their forces accordingly. This resulted in a very tough defensive wall that would meet Model's forces head on. However, the Germans had assembled their main attacking forces in the south as part of Hoth's 4th Panzer Army. This would cause the Russians a few worrying moments in the days ahead. The opening stages of the battle began just before 5 a.m. on the morning of the 5th of July, 1943. Through intelligence sources, the Russians knew when the Germans were going to launch the attack. In a well-planned move, Zhukov ordered the Soviets to launch a preemptive artillery barrage. This strike had the desired result of catching the Germans out in the open during the forming up stage. The ensuing panic and destruction offered a taste of what was to come. To add to the carnage, the Germans now launched their artillery strike. The resulting noise and destruction must have presented a devastating and possibly awe-inspiring sight. Although lasting less than 1 hour in total, this opening phase reached new heights of ferocity. The Russian artillery bombardment delayed the start of the German attack. It did get underway about 2 hours late, with the infantry leading the way.
Naturally, with so much at stake, Hitler used the best troops he had. As for the tanks, of course, he used nearly all of them he had, so there's not much to report about them. On the other hand, infantry divisions and such like, there's to mention Großdeutschland, one of the really top army divisions. By that time, I believe it was already an army corps. And on the other hand, the SS Panzer Corps. Again, the three SS divisions, Totenkopf, Das Reich, and Leibstandarte itself. And from all these old, well-tried divisions from all over the Eastern Front were drawn. They all had to give up troops, usually the best ones, as mentioned, to stiffen the whole attack as much as possible, rather than use a lot of untrained troops.
The 9th Army in the north under Field Marshal Model had four panzer divisions to call on, the 2nd, 9th, 18th and the 20th, plus three heavy tank battalions. The heavy tank battalions consisted of the 505th Heavy Tank Battalion equipped with 30 Tiger and the 653rd and 654th Heavy Tank Battalions equipped with a total of 90 of the new Ferdinand Heavy Tank Destroyer. The emphasis of the German attack lay in the south, with General Hoth's 4th Panzer Army and Army Detachment Kempf. There were a total of 9 infantry divisions in this area, together with the Grossdeutschland Panzer Grenadier Division and the SS Panzer Divisions Leibstandarte Adolf Hitler, Das Reich and Totenkopf. The SS divisions each had a company of 15 Tigers. The Leibstandarte and Das Reich divisions were also equipped with the new Panthers. The crack Grossdeutschland division was also equipped with a Tiger company and a number of Panthers. To back this up, the 503rd Heavy Tank Battalion was also allocated to this section, with a further 45 Tigers. This made for a very impressive lineup, and represented the best that Germany had to offer at the time, both in men and machines. One important area that the Germans lacked in was a suitable reserve force. The Russians had a very sizable reserve to call upon, but the Germans had been badly mauled by 2 years of fighting in Russia and had assembled everything they could spare for a last great throw of the dice. It was not just on the ground that new German weapons were being tested. Hans-Ulrich Rudel, the famous Stuka pilot, was responsible for battle testing a new addition to the Stuka that would prove itself a menace for the Red Army tank men. A 37mm flak cannon was fitted to the underside of the plane. It was found that this weapon was very accurate and very effective at destroying enemy tanks. To make this new weapon work, however, The pilot had to go into a shallow dive and get within close range of his target, a task that presented its own dangers. The number of Russian tanks that fell to this new weapon grew steadily throughout the offensive. As the offensive began to gather momentum, the 9th Army began their advance along the main Oryol to Kursk railway line. They quickly ran into the first defensive line, and the number of casualties began to rise. Within the first 2 days, the 9th Army's attack was halted near Olkhovatka. They had advanced only 12 miles from their start point, but the concentration of the Russian forces in this sector had proved fatal for Model's forces. The revitalized Russian Air Force also helped to defeat the advance.
The Germans had established, once they made up their mind to attack, 16 airfields in the area of Kharkov, which is nearby there. And only on the day before did all the bombers to take part in the battle arrive on these airfields. Nobody knew beforehand what was planned or what was going on. So every of these 16 airfields was packed one day before with German fighter planes and of course the bombers. The next morning, on the morning of the attack, the Russians, about 2 in the morning, it gets about light by 2, 3 o'clock in the morning at the time of the year in Russia, the Russian Air Force approached en masse in hundreds and hundreds of planes, making straight for these German airfields. They were spotted in the last minute, and the report was sent back to these 16 airfields what was happening, imminent attack by Russian bombers. But the airfields themselves had discovered them with long-range radar, which the Russians obviously didn't know the Germans possessed there. So the Germans' fighters took off straight away, and the bombers as well, and about 5 minutes flight time away from the airfields, the Russians were engaged. They had their own fighter screen, of course, their Yaks and Laks, and even a lot of American fighters, air cobras supplied to them. And a tremendous battle developed, and on that one day the Russians alone lost about 430 aeroplanes there, and on the following day another 250. So I don't know how much the Germans lost at the same time, but it was really a blow to them. On the other hand, the Russian Air Force wasn't as much needed as the German was, because the Russians themselves had massed behind their front enormous amounts of heavy and long-range artillery, which done the same job with less trouble. The Germans themselves, of course, started their tank-busting business there with Stuka dive bombers, which had 37mm guns mounted under them, which attacked the T-34s at the back, and I think one man alone, Colonel Rudel, knocked out 36 alone during the years of the campaign. But the Russian Air Force was involved as well, but not from a great point as it might have been.
To compound the problems, the new German tanks that had expected to yield excellent results had performed miserably in battle. The Elephants did start well and had advanced a few miles into enemy territory. Initially, the thick frontal armor proved a good defense against enemy attempts to disable them. They could completely neutralize the enemy infantry positions. Accurate, sustained fire from the Soviet position prevented the German infantry from following behind them. The Ferdinands ran into difficulties when they became separated from their infantry support. The failure to fit an onboard machine gun prevented them from defending themselves against the enemy infantry. The same problems encountered by the Elephant were also seen in the Panther. Many of these tanks broke down on their way to the start point. Another worrying problem for the Panther crews was the fact that many of them caught fire. This was due to a badly designed exhaust system that accumulated unburned fuel that then caught fire. The first model of the Panther earned the nickname of Guderian's problem child. Around 200 of these tanks were sent to the Kursk area. Most broke down. The Tigers, too, experienced problems, especially with the retrieval of vehicles which were damaged by the extensive Russian minefields, which had been insufficiently cleared. A basic oversight which sent Guderian apoplectic with rage. In the south, Hoth's forces got off to a better start.